Hello students, today we are going to discuss on the topic called differential system in automobile. So here are the contents. First one is the introduction, second parts of differential system, third working of differential system, fourth is the case studies, fifth one other function of differential, sixth drawbacks of standard differential, seventh limited slip differential, and the final conclusion. So introduction. What is differential? Differential is an integral part of all four-wheelers. A differential is used to allow the wheels to spin at the different speeds. This is necessary when the vehicle takes a turn. Basically, differential is a mechanical device capable of transmitting torque and make rotation through three shafts. One as an input and other two are as an output for different speed as vehicle makes the turn. Differential allows each of the driving wheels to rotate at different speeds while supplying equal torque to each of them. Now, if there is no differential, then what will happen? Why it is required? So vehicles will rotate at different speeds, mainly when turning the corners or while taking the turn. The differential is designed to drive a pair of wheels with equal torque while allowing them to rotate at the different speed. In vehicle without a differential, such as racing motor, both drive wheels are forced to rotate at the same speed, usually on a common axle drive by simple chain drive mechanism. Now when taking a turn, the inner wheel needs to travel a short distance from the outer wheels. This is the figure. While taking a turn, the inner wheels has to cover less distance compared to the outside wheels. So when cornering, the inner wheel needs to travel shorter distance than the outer wheel. So with no differential, the result is the inner wheel spinning and the outer wheel is the dragging wheel. This will create unpredictable handling, damage to the tires and roads, and strain on the entire drivetrain. This will create an accidental damage. If there is no differential, the inner wheel is spinning, outer wheel is dragging, and it will create serious accidental damage. So this is why the differential is required. Now let's see the parts of differential system. First one is the pinion drive gear. What is the function? Transfer power from the drive shaft to the ring gear. Here it is the pinion gear. This is the pinion gear, which receives the power from the drive shaft and transfers to the ring gear. Second one is the ring gear. It will transfer power to differential case assembly. This is the ring gear, which receives power from the pinion gear. The ring gear will transfer the power to the case assembly. This is the case assembly. The portion, the darker portion, is the case assembly. Spider gears. This is the heart of the differential. The spider gear lies at the heart of the differential, and special mention should be made about its rotation. This is the spider gear, which is connected to the ring gear. When the ring gear rotates, the spider gear start rotating. Next, differential case assembly. This is the differential case assembly. Hold the gear and drive the axle. And last is the rear drive axle, which transfer torque from differential assembly to the driving wheels. This is called the axle, where the left wheel and the right wheel is mounted. It is called the axle. Now working of differential. As we discussed, when turning, the inner and outer wheel have to arc at the different turning radius. The inner wheels try to rotate at the lower radius and outer wheel has to cover more radius. So this is how the differential will work. From the drive shaft, power is transferred to the pinion gear. This is the drive shaft, propeller shaft, from the engine, which is coming from the engine and which will give the power to the pinion gear. So from the drive shaft, power is transferred to the pinion gear. Since the pinion gear and ring gear are meshed, power flows to the ring gear. From pinion gear, the power is flowing through the ring gear. As the spider gear is connected with the ring gear, as we discussed, as I showed, that spider gear is connected with the ring gear. So ring gear will supply the power to the spider gear. And finally, from the spider gear, power gets transferred to the both the side gears. These are the side gears, which will get power from the spider gear. So this is simply pinion gear, it will give power to ring gear. Ring gear will transfer power to the spider gear, and spider gear will rotate these two side gears. This is the simple mechanism. Now let's see the different cases. What will happen when vehicle takes right turn, left turn, and vehicle is moving straight? So first we'll see the case number one, when the vehicle moves straight. In this case, both right and left will have to travel same distance, so same speed is required. There is no turning, so both the wheels have required same speed. Input torque is applied to the ring gear. The input torque is applied to the ring gear, the blue color, which is shown with the blue color, which turns the entire carrier. This is the entire carrier, the blue one. So the input torque is applied to the ring gear, which turns the entire carrier, which is denoted in a blue color, providing torque to both side gears, the red and yellow. This will provide the torque to the both the gears, the red one and the yellow one, which in turn may drive left and right wheels. This will turn the right wheels and the left wheels. What will happen? First, the ring gear is rotating. The ring gear rotates the entire assembly, and it will rotate side gears, both left and the right one. Now here N left is equal to N right, which means RPM on the left side is equal to RPM on the right side. Now if the resistance at both wheel is equal, the spider gear does not spin. This is the spider gear, the green one is the spider gear. It is not spinning. Spider gear is not spinning on its own axis, but it is rotating. There is only one motion. The spider gear rotates along with the ring gear, but does not rotate on its own axis. So the spider gear will push and make both the side gears to turn, and both will turn at the same speed. In short, when the vehicle moves straight, the spider side gear assembly will move as a single solid unit. Let's see in the animation. Here, pinion gear is rotating ring gear is rotating spider gear, but spider gear is only rotating. It is not spinning on its own axis. Here you can see, it is only rotating, but it is not spinning on its own axis. So it will rotate the both two side gears, and the RPM is divided in equal numbers. N left is equal to N right. So this is how the straight motion is working. Now, case number two, vehicle takes a right turn. Now here the differential will create a vital part. Now consider a vehicle taking a right turn. In this case, a certain amount of tension would build up when cornering, as outside wheel tries to rotate quicker than the inside wheel. Here, while taking a right turn, outside wheel has to cover more distance with compared to inner wheels. So the spider gear plays a pivotal role in this case. Along with the rotation of the ring gear, it rotates on its own axis. While moving to a straight, what happened? Spider gear is only rotating. It is not spinning on its own axis. But while taking a right turn, spider gear is rotating as well as it is spinning on its own axis. So the spider gear has a combined rotation. Here, during right turn, left wheel have to travel more than the right wheel. So the speed or reduction of left wheel is more. So the speed required on the left wheel is more. When properly matched, the side gear has to have the same peripheral velocity as the spider gear. Now when the spider gear is spinning as well as rotating, peripheral velocity on the left side of spider gear is the sum of spinning and rotation. Now on left side, while taking a right turn, on left side the sum of the peripheral velocity is sum of spinning and rotating on the left side, while on the left right side it is the difference of the spinning and rotation, because here the rotation of the spider gear is in opposite direction. So here the sum is spinning plus rotation. Here the difference is spinning minus rotation. So the RPM on left side will increase and RPM on right side will decrease. Let's see the animation. Here you can see vehicle is taking a right turn. The spider gear is rotating as well as spinning on its own axis. Also you can see the RPM on the left side is higher compared to the RPM on the right side. The side gear of left side is rotating at high speed and then compared to the side gear on the right side. So this is how differential will plays the vital role while taking a right turn. Now let's see case number 3, when vehicle takes the left turn. Now consider the case when the vehicle is taking a left turn. Here the right wheel have to travel more distance than left wheel. Here, while vehicle taking a left turn, this is the inner wheel, this is the outer wheel. So the left wheel has to cover less distance, the right wheel has to cover more distance. So the RPM required on left side is less compared to RPM required on the right side. Here the right wheel have to travel more distance than the left wheel, that require more rotational speed of the wheel. In this case, the speed of spider gear is in opposite direction as compared to previous case. We discussed in the previous case, it is opposite motion. So the speed of the right hand gear will more because of sum of spinning and rotation velocity of spider gear and contrast to the left side. Here what will happen? In left side, there is a difference between spinning and rotation. In right side, it is the sum of spinning and rotational velocity. So here it is addition, here this is the subtraction. So that's why N left is less than N right. So RPM on the right side is more because of the sum of rotational and spinning velocity, and RPM on the left side is less because of subtraction of the velocities of rotation and the spinning. This is how the vehicle takes the left turn, and the velocities difference will create RPM difference. Now let's discuss the other functional of differential. What is the other functions? First is speed reduction at the pinion ring gear assembly. This is achieved by using a ring gear which is having almost 4 to 5 times number of teeth as that of a pinion gear. This is achieved by using a ring gear which is having almost 4 to 5 times number of teeth as that of a pinion gear. Now this huge gear ratio will bring down the speed of the ring gear in the same ratio. Since the power flow at the pinion and ring gear are the same, such a speed reduction will result in higher torque multiplication. Other function of the differential is to turn the power flow direction by 90 degree, in which the power is transmitted to differential by main shaft and the power further transmitted to rear axle that are mounted at 90 degree with the main shaft. So these are the function of differential. Now drawbacks of standard differential. First drawback is the problem is an open diff always tries to balance the torque. Almost no torque is needed to spin one wheel, and since the open differential always sends the amount of torque to both output shafts, there is no requirement, no torque is needed to spin one wheel. But since the open differential always sends the same amount of torque to both output shafts, if there is no requirement, still open differential wheel is sending the same amount of torque to the both shafts. So to overcome that drawback, one differential is modification is made, is called limited slip differential. So there are two types of differential. First one is the open. We discussed about open differential. Now let's see the limited slip differential. What is limited slip differential and why it is required? So in the case of standard differential is off-roading or snow situation where one wheel brings to slip or lose contact with the ground. In this situation, a limited slip differential will prevent excessive power from being allocated to one wheel and thereby keeping both wheels in power rotation. Simply, let's take an example. If vehicle is moving on a snow surface, if the surface is tractional surface, so if the right wheel is on the low traction and left wheel is on the higher traction, so what will happen? The right wheel tries to slip. It will not rotate, it will not move, it tries to slip. So here the limited slip differential will work. Let's see how. First of all, let's see the construction of the limited slip differential. So the basic component of limited slip differential are pinion gear, ring gear, case, spider gear. Apart from its basic components, a limited slip differential has got a series of frictional and steel plates impact between the side gears and the casing. These are the steel frictional plates. These are the alternate steel plate, frictional plate, steel plate, frictional plate. These are the set of the disc which is connected between side gear and the casing. Now, friction discs are more internal teeth and they are locked with the splines of the side gear. So, the frictional discs as the side gear will always move together. Frictional discs has an internal teeth which is locked with this the side gear and it is work as a single unit. It will rotate along with the side gears. So, this is the construction. Now, let's see the working of limited slip differential. So, now back to initial problem. Since one wheel is on high traction, the torque transmitted to wheel it will be higher. So thrust force developed due to the bevel gear suppression action also will be high at that side. Thus, clutch pack at high tractional wheel side will be pressed firmly. Suppose left wheel is on the high traction. Left wheel is the high traction, right wheel is the on the lower traction. So what will happen? The thrust force developed due to bevel gear suppression action also will be higher at that side. Thus, clutch pack at high tractional wheel side will be pressed firmly and clutch pack will be locked. Here, high thrust is developed. Therefore, because of that, this clutch pack will be locked and the thrust and the torque transmitted on the left side is more compared to the right side. Why? Because on the other hand, clutch pack on the low tractional wheel, right side wheel, is not engaged. So, power flow will be limited at that side. So, the vehicle will be able to overcome the tractional difference problem. Once more, what is happening? Left wheel is on the higher tractional, right wheel is on the lower traction. What is happening? The torque transmitted to left wheel should be higher. So, the thrust force developed due to bevel gear suppression action also will be high at that side. Thus, clutch pack at high tractional wheel side will be pressed firmly and clutch pack will be locked. This clutch pack assembly will be locked on the higher tractional side. So, power from differential casing will flow directly to the higher tractional axle. This is power flow direction. On the other hand, clutch pack on the lower tractional wheel side is not engaged. Here, lower side, the clutch pack is not engaged, so power flow will be limited to that side, so the vehicle will be able to overcome the tractional difference problem and the torque is divided on as per the requirement. Now, conclusion. In automobile and other wheeled vehicles, the differential allows each of the driving wheels to rotate at different speeds while supplying equal torque to each of them. And limited slip differential prevents excessive power from being allocated to one wheel and thereby keeping both wheels in the power rotation. So, this is the conclusion of today's topic. If you have any questions and queries regarding this topic, please mention your queries and questions in the comment section below of this video. I will try to solve your questions and queries as early as possible. Thank you.